Filipino pacifists raise visibility at NY marks World Pride history. New York Filipino transgender advocate Kel Wilier is taking pride of place at the World Pride and Stonewall 50 celebrations here. Counted as this year's largest international pride event that's expected to draw around 5 to 7 million people from around the world this month. NY Governor Andrew Cuomo announced the 11 winners of a statewide competition for World Pride ambassadors on June 13, and among them was Wilier as the representative of Queen Power. History as a leader of the Pride movement is a major point of pride for the state of New York. As we begin Pride Month and mark Stonewall 50, we are recognizing exceptional leaders who will take part in World Pride events to honor our legacy in the continuing fight for equality. Our ambassadors will highlight our history and celebrate our diverse communities in every region of the state, NY Lieutenant Governor Kathy Otto said in a statement. Anniversary of the Stonewall Uprising that many believe to have sparked the global movement for gender equality, making it doubly significant for New Yorkers. My heart is filled with overwhelming joy and happiness, knowing that I win a statewide competition that will showcase how New York City has initiated the gay rights movement, which inspires millions of us all over the world to continue fighting for equality, Wilier told Inquirer.net. The 10 other World Pride ambassadors are Angelique T. Winsky, Ari Moore, Audrey Jesus, Cecilia Gentile, Drew Schitt, Judith Payton Winter, Kelly Metzenberg, Mohamed Q. Amin, Taylor, and Trenor Wilkins. They represent various communities across New York State, from Buffalo to the island of between, according to the NY Governor's Office. I believe that I was chosen to be a World Pride Ambassador because they saw and recognized my potential, that I'm very much capable of inspiring, encouraging and empowering people from all walks of life, particularly the millennials and the marginalized and transgender communities, Wilier said. Among the most famous transgenders in the Filipino-American community, Wilier is a native of Moscow, Maranda, who moved to NY in the early 2000s and has worked as a teacher and healthcare practitioner. She gained prominence as a beauty queen, having won several titles including Miss Pearl of the Orient and Miss Philippines with Beauty, and later a transgender advocate affiliated with the Human Rights Campaign of Greater New York. As the World Pride Ambassador for Queens, which is one of the most ethnically diverse neighborhoods not only in NY but in the entire United States, Wilier expects to promote and highlight the diversity of her neighborhood's community, including the historic and iconic destinations of the state throughout the Pride Month celebration. She will be featured in one of the floats during the NYC Pride March on June 30th. About 50 Filipinos are also taking on official duties during the live musical event Pride Island on June 29-30 at the Hudson River Park. A highlight of the World Pride and Stonewall 50 celebration with tickets selling out as early as March, Pride Island is set to draw a crowd of 7,000. Grace Jones and popular NYC DJ Johnny Dinnell headline Pride Island Saturday, while Madonna concludes the celebration with a few choice songs on Pride Island Sunday. Filipinos will be manning the ticket lines on Pride Island Sunday as registered volunteers of Social Wars, which was officially selected as an NYC Pride Working Grant Program recipient this year. Let's Square Graphic Disclosure, this reporter is the founder and executive producer of Social Wars. Right Square Graphic from 12:30 p.m. to 11 p.m. Social volunteers are responsible for maintaining an excellent guest experience at the ticket line. They will manage the queue, direct guests to proper lanes, scan tickets, place or remove risks spent on guests, and keep the service areas clean until the concert ends at around 11 p.m. This is the second year in a row of TOFA joining NYC Pride as a community partner. Four of its volunteers, Donna San Pablo, Lauren Egerton, Jovic Cruz, and Sherwin Ray, the designated team leaders and assistant team leaders, started training for their roles last week. According to Ross D. Levi, NY State Executive Director, major events have been planned statewide as part of the World Pride and Stonewall 50 celebration, spanning Long Island to Niagara Falls, including commemorations of the Stonewall Uprising in NYC. As a World Pride Ambassador, Dr. Weilier plans to tell visitors what she finds to be the best thing about NYC. I would tell any visitor that New York is the best place to be free and safe. It is so diverse, very inclusive and gay-friendly city. It is a city that embraces and welcomes anyone, regardless of color, religion, sexual orientation or gender identity. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.